Good morning. This morning we're going to be making Italian wedding soup. I've got two new assistants. They're a whole lot prettier than I am, but I'm sure that they'll do the job. Italian wedding soup is, we have tiny meatballs. We'll show you how you make it. There's pasta, there's dried escarole, and cheeses and stuff like that. We have chicken broth, and we're going to have a nice feed later on. And incidentally, I'd like to tell a little story about this soup. Growing up in an Italian family, if your daughter came home with a boyfriend, and she had been going with him, say, for a year or so, and she asked you to cook, make something for dinner, and invite him to dinner because he had never had dinner there. And normally, mother would make Italian wedding soup. And the thing about this is that your daughter, knowing how it went, if she came home and her boyfriend was going to be eating Italian wedding soup, she knew that the family approved of her. If the soup was a little lesser, it was like this, you know, she was still on probation. So that was the story with
that. That's the story.
So we're going to show you how to make these meatballs. And Chris Ligotti, she's one of the big guys here.
Yeah.
She's going to be helping me, and pretty soon we're going to have Lisa, and we're going to have some fun.
Yeah.
So if you go over there,
not the one this side.
Get a chair, rub a little oil on your hand, just, okay. Now, we're going to take this. This has all been prepared. This is good hamburger, and I've put in onions and parsley and Romano cheese and salt and pepper and stuff. And I don't think that even this young lady would know how to make small meatballs.
No, they're tiny. I'm not used to that.
So I want you to just take one, and I don't want you to squeeze it too tight.
Okay.
Right? Because the reason why I want to leave it loose is I want some of the flavor to come out in the soup. See?
Okay. So you kind of make a log out. You make a long.
Make a log.
A log. And then you take a small piece and just lightly circle it.
That's exactly what you do.
All right. Got it.
And it really isn't.
And do you cook those in the oven or do you cook them?
I just brown them in a frying pan.
Okay.
And then they'll cook in the soup.
All right. And they're really all the same size. Nice job.
Well,
that's what you want, right?
That's what I want.
Okay. Are you going to make another log?
I'll make another log.
Okay. This is the perfect time of the year for this, Reno.
Yes,
a nice soup in the fall. There's nothing better.
Don't put your fingers in there. We don't like fingers in soup. Okay.
Hi, Lisa.
Hi.
Come on over. You can help.
Okay. Let me put an apron on.
It's down here.
There's one. Oh, you got another.
Oh, she wants a
sexy. I got a blue one that matches my
blue
shirt.
She wants to match.
She wants a sexy.
You know how we are, the girls. We got to match our outfits.
How are we today? I'm going to wash my hands.
Good idea.
All right, Reno. What do you got for me?
Come on, Lou. Get over there.
Okay. Hi, Mona.
Hi.
Chris. Put a little oil on your hand.
Ooh, should I take my rings off? I think I will.
And I've already made over 150. These are all.
Oh my goodness.
These are all.
How's that?
It's going to be a good lunch today, Reno.
So what we do here, Lisa, is we make them. a ball, and then we make a rope. And it makes it so much easier rather than picking out.
Well, it smells good. What's in the meatballs?
Romano cheese, salt, pepper, pasta, basil, and just about it.
Any onion?
Onion really diced. You can see them.
Small
diced really, really fine.
Okay. Those are perfect little meatballs, aren't they?
Aren't they?
Yeah, it's impressive.
The perfect size.
Yep. I think that system works.
You know, some people do this, and they'll pick a piece, and one will come small, one will come ball. Big. This way here, they'll all come the same size, and when people eat them, they say, gee, somebody's doing a good job.
That makes sense. That really does.
So what's the purpose of putting the oil on your hands before you roll the meatballs? I've never done that before.
Yeah.
Well, these are going to be in the fry pan now. We're going to saute them, turn them brown. One of you guys is going to do it.
Okay.
And we're just going to partially cook them, and then the rest we want to cook in the chicken broth because you want to get some of the flavor from it.
But it also makes it so it doesn't stick, right, Reno?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Is this how you do your meatballs, Mary? No, you do them different? Everybody has their own way, I guess.
This is specific for this. The soup, though, the wedding soup.
This is easier than I've done, because I do, like you said, take a little bit out, but they don't all come.
Well, see, Mary, you learned something.
Oh, yeah, see that?
I just learned something.
Learning something every day.
Well, it's a good tip, I think.
So you have Romano cheese, parsley, and what else?
Basil. Chopped onion real fine, salt and pepper, and eggs.
And eggs.
Oh, already.
That it? Oh, we got
one more piece.
Got another little piece here.
What kind of hamburger are you set up?
What kind of hamburger, Reno? That's what Mary was asking.
That's real, as good a hamburger as you can buy. It's got to be all lean.
Just beef hamburger, though.
Chopped
beef
meat. Or something?
Chopped sirloin kind of thing?
That's about right.
How's that, Reno? How'd I do?
You see where you see a belly, you just do it in the belly, sort of.
All right,
Do
it in the belly.
There you go, well.
Oh, you want me to cut it? You're gonna cut it?
No, I want you to cut it.
All right, I'm gonna start from this end.
So you don't put pork or anything else, ground pork or veal?
That's a good meatball. I love meatballs. That's my best Italian accent.
I don't know. I give it a fair. Good try though. I wouldn't even attempt it.
What we're doing is we're gonna put just a little bit of broth, and we're gonna cook the veggies that are gonna go into the soup. We've got them all cut, and we're going to turn on the stove lightly.
What are the vegetables?
Well, actually, it's carrots and onions, and we grated the onions, and I cut they grated the carrots, and we cut the onions, and now we will.
I think that's just great, Reno, that you grated the carrots. Did you grate the onions too, or you just chopped them?
I just chopped them.
Oh, it looks beautiful.
I think I need a little more broth.
The broth, okay. One of these, Reno, or this?
Oh, I got it right here.
Oh, okay. All right.
Now, when these are cooked...
So you're just going to soften them?
Yeah, I'm going to soften them. What, all we're going to do is soften them up so that in the juice from the veggies is going to go into the chicken broth, okay? What we're going to do is we need a little olive oil.
Olive oil. Here you go.
And now this is where we're at, browning the meatball, right?
We're going to brown the meatball.
Okay.
A little olive oil.
And we're just going to put in a few because these got to be, now, these got to be tended to very carefully.
Okay.
So we're going to turn this on.
Meatballs.
We're going to brown the meatballs, but only brown them because we want the flavor that comes from the meatballs to go into the soup. So we'll just brown these and we'll finish cooking them in the chicken broth. And one of you girls who's going to do this, come over here. Okay.
Which thing do you want me to work on?
That one there is, we don't have to touch that one.
Okay.
This one here.
Kind of flip them around?
Yeah. You can't let them get crusty, okay?
Okay, all right.
About leaving them for a minute and then roll them again.
Okay.
Any way you want.
All right.
By rolling the pan.
Okay, let's see what happens. Give them a second to warm up.
And try to drain the oil from a little bit. That girl.
All right.
You're doing great.
I'm learning, Reno.
No, you're doing well.
I don't want to hide the pasta. So are you going to use this, Reno, to drain it? I think you brought this.
Yes, I did. I'm going to.
Because they're
so
tiny.
You
can't.
Yeah, well, that's it. That's it.
Yeah.
This is going to take
a few minutes, right?
That's not done. Now I gotta turn this off for now. And I'm going to... Cold water.
So why are you doing the cold water?
Keep it from cooking, overcooking.
Oh, okay, because you want it to stop
now. It's going to cook in the other thing.
It's still hot?
It's still hot.
Okay. So those little pastas just got a little bit bigger, not a whole lot.
Right.
They're tiny.
I think this is about ready for some meatballs.
All right. Is that what you're going to do? Just put these in?
Yeah.
All of them?
Yeah.
All righty.
Just dump them all in.
All right. Easy enough.
Yeah, it's going to be a very, very rich soup.
Oh, yeah, that's the way we like it, don't we?
Yeah, absolutely.
So what's escarole?
It's...
Looks like spinach, but it's a little thick.
It's thicker than spinach.
Something's in the refrigerator.
Is that it right there?
Yeah, this is the one that's been cooked and chopped.
Oh, okay.
That's already in here.
So what does it taste like? Is it different than collard?
Yeah, it is. That only comes out in the winter.
Oh.
It's around November 1st, you start getting escarole. And it's for salad, it is really good because.
Is it okay to put this in the boiler now?
Oh, please, yeah. But time it. Stay with it.
Stay with it.
The minute starts turning tan, pull it out.
All right. That one will take long.
Salt, pepper.
So we drain the pasta. I need something with the bread.
Romano should give it a good flavor.
Good.
We're not gonna add it to the soup just yet, though.
Not just yet.
So put it over here.
How thick is this? Somebody want to cut that and put that in your
yeah.
Serving dish?
I know, we're looking for a dish.
Why don't you cut a bowl at the same time and save yourself some
money? All right, I know what you're talking about. You're right.
There we go.
Double it up. I gotta get the other one out though. Oh, okay. Hold on. I don't want this to burn. All right, one more batch. Well, Reno did all the work. All I had to do was pop it in the oven.
That's not so.
That's good.
This is the finished soup. You see there's the meatballs and the pasta and the escarole. And this is ready to go.
It is an important job, isn't it? Setting the table with a smile.
That looks great.
How's that?
That looks absolutely great.
Perfect. It's high, high, high to the touch. All right. Reno's right. Double it up, and then you only do it once. Oops, I'm sorry. So I was going to take
hot.
That away. So
there we go.
What size would you need? Woo!
Burn your fingers.
I'm burning my fingers.
Use the thing in the bag. There you go.
Well, it's all right. I'll just do it quick.
They'll get you an elbow glove.
Woo!
You want your pot on the other side? This is even going to take
the
dishes
over
here.
Sure, we'll put the pot over there.
Okay.
You want me to do it, Reno? Move the pot. Is it finished?
I'll do it. It's kind of heavy for you.
Reno, I'm cool to the gym.
I work out.
I work out.
Here, Reno.
I got it.
All right.
I get a ladle in your business.
Is that a big enough ladle? Yeah. I'll do it if you want.
Yeah,
Who's going to have some soup? Everybody, pull up and have a seat. Well, sit with us and have some food.
You have good
food. So you get to Mary, pull your chair forward so you can sit with us, okay? Yeah. I want to put your chair in the way.
Yeah.
Take one for yourself.
Would you like some?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right.
Tomato cheese?
Yeah. You want some soup, my
kind? A little extra cheese,
Mary. Have a seat. Go.
Yeah.
Can you sit over there? Yeah. How about some bread? Want a piece of bread, Jean? No? How about you, McKenna?
McKenna.
Okay. She's my youngest.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm
Reno.
You going to have some of these?
Of course I am. Reno, compliments to the chef. The soup is delicious.
Well, thank you. Well, Lisa, you have yours.
Courtney.
I mean, Courtney. Have yours with Vivian?
Yeah. Is it good? Of course it is. We don't need it. Mm-hmm.
Nobody's talking. They're all eating.
I know. That's how I get when I eat, too. I don't usually eat this, Reno, but I'll eat it because you need it.
So, Reno, when you had dinner at Alma's house, did her mom make you Italian wedding soup?
Her mother hated me.
Oh! So what did you get?
She told my wife, yes, I hate him. He's too big for you. He said it'll never last.
How long ago was that?
We were married 65 years.
Sometimes mom doesn't always know best, right?
No, we didn't.
This is the quietest
it's been
with one of these.
I'm glad you
liked
it. And McKenna's taking care of it.
You gotta shut up.
You're
just
keep
talking.
So you have to marry a Italian man.
McKenna's dad is Italian.
No, I'm off that thing.
Yeah.
But it looks delicious.
Yeah.
Is it good? Mm-hmm.
Well, I had some great help today, and I might put them on the payroll. And, things are doing well. I think the soup came out excellently. I think everybody enjoyed it. And next month, we'll see you again. And I think we're going to make spaghetti aglio olio, which means spaghetti with garlic and olive oil and anchovies.
Oh, wow.
You lost me anchovies, but okay.
This show often talks to people who have interesting hobbies or careers or different things that they have going on that affect our community.
I'm Mary Arnott, your host.
There is a huge need for providing food for individuals and family.
And that's the key.
That's the key.
Yeah. It's working well together.
You can see more episodes online at our website, hkim.tv.
Hi, I'm Tim Kilduff, and this is Business Matters.
I think we got to talk a little bit about the history. I mean, you were born into something pretty special, weren't you?
Yeah.
The shop is a safe haven for a lot of people, young and old.
Business Matters is HKM's show focusing not only on businesses in Hopkinton, but more importantly, the people who run and manage those businesses.
Just a minute, folks.
It's Diving Driving time, and we got a great Western for you today.
Diving Driving is a new program featuring the HKM staff's favorite B movies. We hope you enjoy these treasured films of yesteryear.
And even if we don't get paid, there ain't no job we trade. We're hauling freight to stay to stay along with better pay.
So check out the HKM TV website at hkm.tv for movie games and showtimes.
Thank you.
Hi, welcome to Great Gardens.
Just make sure that you water regularly and through November.
So I think we can go ahead and start backfilling here.
I think fall is one of the best times to plant roses.
When you can squeeze your soil and hold it together, that's good.
Welcome to Hopkinton Coffee Break.
A very special dessert done by a woman from Hopkinton that I've started using regularly.
We had your residents participating both as vendors and as shoppers, and that was so much fun.
Real Hopkinton Housewives, if you're on Facebook, you will have a blast. Thanks for joining
us. Cheers, guys.
It's been a great...
Thank you.
Yeah, good to see you,
too. See you, guys.
Bye.
Hi, I'm Cheryl Perrault, host of the program Meet Your Neighbor on HCAM TV.
Kids got so much on their plate, and they're traveling here and they're traveling there.
You know, they still need help from time to time.
My father always was outdoors. I mean, he grew up, he had pet baby squirrels.
This show introduces you to Hopkinton residents, the many interesting people who are our neighbors, and we invite them to share stories, experiences, insights, and observations from their lives.
I'm Dr. Bruce Carlin. Welcome to Physician Focus.
A caregiver's burden can take people by surprise and seem overwhelming.
More than 1 in 3 Americans are living with prediabetes.
Complicated grief can increase the risk of physical and mental illness, substance abuse, and suicide.
Healthy eating promotes good health and reduces the risk of chronic illness.
People will get arm pain. About 80 to 90% of people have arm pain after the HPV vaccines.
Welcome to the Senior View. And today we have some very special guests who do some very special work.
We've done a lot of charity quilts. We've done quilts for veterans. We've done quilts for the Serenity House.
So we try to figure out, what are your goals? What's your time frame? What's your motivation for moving? What's the situation with the house?